Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of bear. Exclusively at the Home Depot.
Welcome to ESPN College Football presented by McDonald's. Howard Homecoming from the Mecca. The Bison bleed blue, you already know. Howard hosting a streaking Norfolk State Spartan team, winners of four straight as they kick off MEAC play. What's up, fam? Glad to have you back with us alongside the former Howard University and NFL quarterback Jay Walker. I'm Tiffany Green, and games starting to mean something again here in Green City, and much like when you played.
For the first time in a very long time, Howard playing a meaningful conference game here at home. They've won two games in a row. They're playing their best football under the Larry Scott era, but they're taking on a very talented team in Norfolk State with Dawson Odoms in his first year down there, the leader of the Spartans. This is a really good football team.
Well, the last time we saw Howard, they picked up a W here at Green Stadium via shutout. Now they're coming off a bye week, fresh legs, and Quentin Williams a part of the factor that makes Howard what it is. QB play is going to be at a premium this weekend.
It sounds like a cliche, but it's really the truth in this game right here, and I'll tell you why. Juwan Carter, the preseason offensive player of the year in the Mideastern Athletic Conference, he's playing like it, playing at a very high level, great turnover to touchdown interception ratio, and Quentin Williams, playing quarterback at Howard is a very difficult position because of the tradition, but when he's playing well, this is an explosive offense, but when he struggles, they struggle mightily. Quarterback play will be the key. Whoever plays the best out of those two guys will probably lead his team to victory.
Well, Norfolk State coming in, as we mentioned, winners of four straight. You go back to October 2nd, that big overtime win against Hampton. They put up 40-plus points in the last two. Meanwhile, Larry Scott in his first full season as head coach of the Bison, he's got his team rolling, winners of two straight. Dawson Odoms coming over from Southern University, moving into the MEAC, and thus far, behold the green and gold, as they like to say, and Norfolk, he is a winner, and he's bringing that tradition back to the Spartans. We are underway from Green Stadium, and on the return, Matthew McDonald, the wide receiver. McDonald crossed the 25 as he's brought down, and the first time we'll get a chance to see that Howard offense, who again put up 27 points against Morgan State as there's penalty markers flying onto the field late. Well, that's the way to get the momentum going here, Jay. A flag to start things off from Howard Homecoming.
Well, everybody wants to get a little piece of the celebration. Everybody's a little excited. Penalty on the play. Coach Scott trying to sell his guys down, and whoever can settle down their squad first.
All right, we have two fouls on the play, both on the receiving team. Holding, receiving team number four. That penalty would be declined. Holding, receiving team number 12. That would be penalized from the end of the run, 10 yards. First down, Howard.
Hear from Jay Edwards and this MEAC officiating crew, so that'll back up Larry Scott. Naturally not where you want to start inside your own 20, but we saw, a 97 drive a couple of weekends ago?
Yeah, one play, longest pass play in Howard University history. Quentin Williams was able to connect. See if he can draw some of that magic now. And if you're Norfolk State, opportunity to really put the Bison offense behind the eight ball early.
DMV area kid and Quentin Williams out of Upper Marlboro, Maryland. We saw him put up 337 passing yards, two TDs in that win over Morgan State.
It's something about Quentin, which, you know, it's always tough when you're playing, when you come in behind like a legend or a really good player, and people don't realize Kalen Newton was the guy at Howard. Kalen decided not to play, and all of a sudden, as a true freshman, Quentin Williams was thrust into the starting position, and he has not given it up. He's got a stranglehold on it. He's the leader of this offense, trying to make his own mark, be a Howard legend.
Well, he's come from a winning tradition. Dr. Henry Wise played for a dynasty at Wise High School, winning a couple of state titles, and now he's looking to lead the Bison to perhaps contention at least for a MEAC title.
To spot the ball correctly.
I'm ready to play some football.
Right.
Are the officials ready? I'm ready to see some football. We got a big time matchup here. Let's go.
On the first play out to Richie Ilaraza, and Ilaraza with a completion, a short pickup, and they're saying it's incomplete. Stuart Anderson was there wolfing him down.
One of the things that Howard likes to do is a lot of RPOs, getting Williams out of the pocket, moving the pocket. Offensive coordinator Lee Hull, not really a big fan of drop back passing, likes to use some misdirection, try to get wide receivers open schematically.
Christian Carter in motion. Jared Hunter gets the handoff up ahead. The all-purpose back for the Bison with a gain of about four, stopped by R.J. Coles. Hunter, we saw him, the sophomore out of Mineral, Virginia. He's a guy who has the ability to make guys miss. They will need him to execute on the ground.
And last week, the last time Howard played, rushed for 117 yards. If he can have any type of productivity similar to that, really help out this offense.
Third and six. Quickly getting it out, and Antoine Murray can't come up with it. That'll bring up fourth down. So a three and out on Howard's opening drive. The defense of Norfolk State trying to make a statement here early.
And that's a throw as a college quarterback. You have to complete that pass. You've got a third down situation, crossing route in front of you. Stand firm in the pocket, deliver a strike. He threw that football fading away, and that's why it was an incompletion.
Dylan West standing on his own 5-yard line to boot it away. Justin Smith awaiting near midfield, calls for the fair catch. And Jawan Carter, we mentioned the preseason MEAC Offensive Player of the Year. And Jawan Carter, we talked about how he's been balling this season. First All-MEAC quarterback since 2011. 23 touchdown passes. You see how they have shaken out over his career in this season. Better than 1,200 yards passing and leading the conference in completion percentage. So Jawan Carter, the fifth-year senior out of Richmond, Virginia, who has really developed into a great leader when we talked to the coaches this week.
Leadership ability, the dual threat is really there. The passing numbers have improved, but let's not forget, I call him like ZZ Top. He's got legs, and he knows how to use them. He is a dual threat guy. When he pulls it and tucks it to call his own number, that's when he's most dangerous.
The pitch out, and Aaron Walker coming up with the stop. Undersized linebacker right here in Washington, D.C. Well, Jawan Carter, we talked about just how effective he can be with his legs. You know, he understands this system. He's been in it for a while, and he's a guy that can make you miss on a run. Second and eight. Handoff to J.J. Davis. Davis with a cut and some moves, and Davis with a strong run on second down to pick up the first down and move the sticks. J.J. Davis transferred in from Cincinnati, and he's been leading the pack in that backfield.
And take a look at big number 70, Justin Redd, coming around the formation, 6'5", 315 pounds. That's a lot of man. Good job of setting up the blocker by Davis. That's how they executed that play. They brought the right guard across the formation to create a wall.
Dual running backs split between Carter. There's Brent, Cameron Brent. The tough two, Kenny Gallup coming up with the stop.
That's one of those college football plays, or any level football. Boring play. First down, 2 yards. That was a collision between Walker and Brent on that play there. So much so, you take a hit, you don't mind sitting out of play.
And on second and eight, Justin Smith, the leading receiver in motion. Carter drops back, takes it down underneath, and the pass is complete. A pickup of about 4 or so. Kendall James is the completion there. So third and four. For this Spartans offense. Howard, 30-yard line. And the pass incomplete. Good coverage there. Coming across.
Trying to hit Justin Smith on the crossing route there, and not able to get to him. That's a ball. I think Smith has to make that catch to help out your quarterback there. You're the go-to wide receiver. The coverage was pretty tight by Knightley. However, make that play right there to keep the drive alive.
So Josh Nardone on to attempt the field goal. 47-yard attempt. The kick is up. And it's no good. The missed field goal, and we're still got goose eggs on the board here from Howard Homecoming.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come, like Stainmaster with lifetime stain resistance limited warranty. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
ESPN College Football is presented by McDonald's Black and Positively Golden Movement, elevating the next generation of Black excellence, and in part by the Walt Disney World Resort 50th Anniversary Celebration.
Homecoming step show. How about everybody out and about on the yard in Crampton at the Mecca, Jay, and looking inside Green Stadium. Good crowd on hand to witness this very important MEAC game as Norfolk State in their conference opener against Howard.
A lot on the line, and both teams coming out missing opportunities. And I think if you're Howard, you have to be fortunate still at 0-0 game. They had a three and out in their first possession. Now they're getting off to a good start running the football successfully here on first down. Hunter on the
carry. Jared Hunter with a 7-yard pickup on first down. Stopped by Stuart Anderson. And then one of the things that we talked with Lee Hall about this week, the offensive coordinator, saying, look, what we must do is execute. Very simple. There were things that we left on the table even in our shutout win a couple of weeks ago. Must execute and not beat ourselves. Second and short, the pass across and coming down awkwardly, but still making the catch is the tight end. That's Brennan Brown, who moved back to tight end. Brown, playing some on the O-line.
Look at the concentration by Brown. Seeing this ball in, gets hit. Awkward landing there. Fortunate to see he's able to jog off the field somewhat. No hit coming over from the defensive back, R.J. Coles. Dangerous play there. We'll see if Brown's able to shake it off.
Bryce Bison across midfield at the Norfolk State 45. There's Casey Hawthorne out of the... An easy pass and catch from Williams to Hawthorne and move the chains once again.
You know why this worked? Jared Hunter being unselfish. Start running back number 22. They line him up in the slot. He's right there standing in the middle. Watch him make the defensive back go inside, then back around to shield him. That created the running lane for Hawthorne. Nicely designed and executed play by the offense.
The handoff to Ian Wheeler. Wheeler, the first carry of the ball game for the junior out of Houston. Pickup of a couple.
If you're Norfolk State, this is where you want some of your big name guys. Their defense is led by their defensive ends, Deshaun Dixon, an NFL prospect, along with Chris Myers, number 98. Huge defensive end, 6'6 and 6'5, 250 pounds. You need them to make a play to disrupt this offense.
Here's Wheeler again, a change of speed kind of guy. Instead, coming up from his free safety position was Stuart Anderson. Anderson, who is a former wide receiver, converted to safety.
Yeah, and this is how you play the position. You're trying to stretch it out wide. You'll see him just kick into a second gear, able to make the tackle behind the line of scrimmage against Wheeler.
Coach is really high on him, a great deal of respect Dawson Odom has for Stuart Anderson. Third and nine coming up here for Howard. Williams has time, gets it out and intercepted. Standing in front of the pass, that's Tavion Land.
What a play. Tremendous break on the ball by Tavion Land. You're gonna throw the ball outside across the field, you have to do it on time. And you have to see it. He kind of floats it in a great undercut by Land for the interception. That's highlight reel material there.
He's known around campus as Tank, but he comes and swoops in and grabs that interception and changing the momentum for Norfolk State.
And how aggressive was that break? Because if you take that route, that angle, and you miss, there was nobody behind him. That would have been a touchdown. Great individual effort, aggressive angle, but he was rewarded with the pick.
And you know Dawson Odoms loves to see that, a defensive-minded head coach. So now another chance for Juwan Carter to move this offense for the Spartans. Cameron Britton going right up the gut and not much going.
Cameron Britton on the carry.
When you see Carter, and I'm a little surprised at the game plan here. This is a Norfolk State offense that's operating kind of methodical right now. You know, you watch Carter, he's got a lot of poise. But I don't really see a sense of urgency. If I'm the team that's higher ranked, or the top ranked teams in HBCU football going on the road, I want to go up tempo and try and establish we're the better team early.
Again, Carter with time, taking a shot. That's Justin Smith making the adjustment and couldn't get to it in time. Elijah Coleman on the coverage, but Smith trying to kind of run across the near side to try to pick up that one and unable to do so.
It's hard when you're asking a defensive back to cover wide receiver all the way across the football field. And they were just fortunate that Smith was not able to hold on. Catchable pass. They just missed on a big play opportunity. Be careful of Carter running the football in these situations if you're Howard.
Carter instead elects to pass. It's complete to Marquis Ellington, and Ellington picks up enough for the first down. A gain of 8. Ellington is one of those wide receivers, when we talked with the coaches, just getting better and better.
And here just they're faking the blitz. Find the soft spot in the zone, know where the first down yardage is, make the catch. Easy play, nice execution at Norfolk State.
State coming in with the top-ranked offense in the MEAC. And it's because Juwan Carter can make plays, scramble, make nothing out of something or something out of nothing.
And that's what, you know, as the season goes on, I always tell you, when your offensive coordinator calls a pass play on first down, what does he want, Tiff? Just wants positive yards.
Yeah.
Right?
Move forward.
No incompletion, give us positive yards, whether it's 2, 3, 4, 5. When they call pass plays on first down, pick up positive yards. Carter right there didn't like what he saw, picked up 5 yards. His offensive coordinator, B.T. Sherman, will live with that all day.
the handoff to Kevin Johnson, and Johnson is stuck, really nowhere to go. That's Darian Brokenberg.
Brokenberg,
who is strong, fast, physically gifted in there. Good stop.
And this is how you win your battle at the line of scrimmage. Watch number three, this manhandle. A tight end trying to block a legitimate defensive end should be no competition. And Brokenberg able to penetrate behind the line of scrimmage and minimize that run play single-handedly by himself.
You see Brokenberg's numbers on the season. Very good pass rusher as well. Third and four for the Spartans. The handoff to J.J. Davis. He's got blocking along that far side, and Davis with running room, but there's a flag back near midfield.
But there are flags on the play. Doing the run, holding, 32 offense. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Replay, third down.
Look at number 32. He's the lead blocker. Sealing the edge and took him down. Unnecessary. I mean, that's one where mentally you want to say, just screen him, get in the way. He was already running himself out of the play. But Lex Henry, obvious hole, cost him a first down.
That backs him up, 45-yard line to gain in Bison territory. Obvious passing situation here. Carter standing back, surveying, has a man on the outside, and that's Daquan Felton. Felton with a wonderful grab, getting it out of the air, and Felton puts him back across midfield.
Now this is beautiful. They're playing cover two, man-to-man, man underneath, safety help over the top. You have to thread that ball in that small window before the safety's able to become part of the play. You see, he freezes number 14, Kenny Gallup, the safety on the hash, throws it in the sweet spot. Big time throw and catch from Norfolk State.
Here's Lex Henry on the carry, and Henry was stopped. No gain on the play.
Lex Henry.
Mention this Norfolk State team and just how well they have played. See a break in the action with an injured player on the field for Howard. That looks like big number 97, Jevin Jackson. One of their interior linemen being tended to. 5:35 to go in this first quarter. We will step aside quickly from the nation's capital. They want to come back with us.
Bison Sports on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for daily updates on everything Bison.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come, like Stainmaster with lifetime stain resistance limited warranty. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
Looking at the journeys of Dawson Odoms and Larry Scott, they took two different paths. Head coach at Southern, Dawson Odoms, had great success with the Jaguars. Meanwhile, it was Larry Scott who took the Power 5 route. He was even the interim head coach of Miami. And while Dawson Odoms saw success there, he wanted to do something different, do something special, hire back in April for Norfolk State. And Larry Scott said he wanted to be here to be a great leader of men, and both of them are doing a terrific job.
I feel that both programs are lucky to have both of them. You know, for Odoms going to Norfolk State, that was a big coup. When they got him from Southern University with his winning tradition, big come up for Norfolk State. I think for Coach Scott, his first head coaching job, you know, full time, not replacing somebody. He's got that passion. He's a leader of men. He's a leader of men and likes the challenge. And I think Howard's fortunate to keep him because we know that he turned down an offer to go coach at Alabama to stay here at Howard University.
Juwan Carter was keyed in on the entire way. That's Kenny Gallup coming up to make the stop. Young guy who's gotten some experience, and after those couple of exhibition games in the spring, doing a great job, brings up fourth down. Now, decision time here for Dawson Odoms and what he decides to do. Josh Nardone, their field goal kicker, missed a 47-yarder. Looks like Juwan Carter is staying on the field to try to pick up 3 yards.
And they may try and get him to jump offside, but surprise, why would you not go for it when you're a little bit closer? 47-yarder before, now this would be a 40-yarder. He didn't miss by that much. I'd be shocked if they decide to go for this situation.
Carter scrambling, going to his left, throwing, gets the pass away, and somehow Justin Smith comes up with the one-handed grab.
Playing it risky, unconventional from Dawson Odoms, going for it on fourth and three, not taking the points. And this is just a great job of Justin Smith working, fighting, knowing his quarterback was scrambling, fourth down. We have to make a play. And these are just the athletes making athletic things happen on the football field.
Great ball skills by Justin Smith. And way to keep that play alive by the legs of Juwan Carter, now inside the red zone. First and goal. You see the success the Spartans have had this season. 20 TDs on 29 possessions. The flip quickly in motion and nowhere to go as Kevin Johnson is dragged down by Ray Williams.
Good job by the Bison defensive line, particularly the cornerback, Ray Williams, sealing the edge. This is supposed to be a jet sweep, but Williams makes a great tackle. Nowhere to go for the ball carrier.
So loss of 7 on that play, backs him up.
Watch number 83, bottom of your screen. Daquan Felton, 6'4", may give him a jump ball situation.
And right there, even though it's collected, it's Elijah Coleman coming up with the tackle. So third and goal now for Norfolk State. Justin Smith has been their go-to target, number 3, who kept this drive alive, which started back at the 32-yard line of Norfolk, but also, as you mentioned, Daquan Felton as well, their biggest rideout.
And I like this. Put Smith up there with Felton on that side to really put pressure on the defense.
Carter with all kinds of time. Still looking, gets it out and into the hands of Daquan Felton. Touchdown, Spartans.
Can't blame that on the secondary. I mean, how long can they cover for? I mean, he was back there for eternity. Even with it being a 3-man rush, you have to get more pressure on this. I mean, what are you standing around looking for? Attack the pocket. They went out there and had to attack them. And this is just Juwan Carter being Juwan Carter, buying time until his receiver was open. Felton, who we knew they kind of wanted to go to down in the end zone.
Felton's first touchdown of the season.
Is under previous review.
We'll take a look at it, maybe the catch, but give credit to that offensive line up front, too. I mean, Carter had tons of time in the pocket. This is at the end of the play. He was open for a while.
It's
a touchdown.
Yeah, clearly a touchdown. But yeah, you could count like 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi to about like 6.
Again, that's why I said give it Jeff Woods, Jalen Powell, Colby Bird, Justin Redd, and Demontre Smith. You all get a high five from me. That was tons of time for Carter to find a receiver.
Yeah, spoken like a true quarterback, because that's what you have to do. You have to make sure you thank your O-line for creating those opportunities for you to shine.
Yeah, if I don't get touched, I really like it if I don't get touched. I mean, he's just buying the time, and that was all about having time for the receivers to fight to get open and find a crease. Jay Edwards confirms the touchdown, which we knew, but nice drive put on by Norfolk State. That key fourth down conversion with Carter and Smith connecting, able to keep the drive going. And no surprise, look at Dawson Odoms going for it on fourth down. I just knew he was going to take those 3 points. That's normally what he would do.
And also not a quick strike offense. I mean, they were methodical, as you mentioned, which kind of puzzled you a little bit, Jay, about, you know, the way they were able to orchestrate a drive, 14 plays, 68 yards, and better than 7 minutes off the clock. Nardone. The extra point is good. So the top-rank scoring offense in the MEAC is on the board first. They're on the road, and Jawan Carter doing big things, finding Daquan Belton for the TD.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear. Exclusively at the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come, like Stainmaster with lifetime stain resistance limited warranty. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
Yeah, for sure. Let's go back to Norfolk State and the success that they have had over the last four games. They've strung together a handful of wins, their first four-game winning streak in the last 10 years, and these are the numbers that they have been able to pull it up. They're trying to find that first winning season in more than a decade.
Yeah, and listen, you know, when they had Latrell Scott, who was a previous coach prior to Odom, he was an offensive guy. He cared about that offense and really put it there. And give credit to Dawson Odoms. He's like, I'm not touching the offense. I'll get the defense fine-tuned. And that last loss, November 23rd, 2019, I had to look it up. Now, the easy guess would have been North Carolina A&T. The last team to beat them, South Carolina State. And a lot of people think that game at the end of the season, November 20th, could be for the MEAC title, South Carolina State versus Norfolk.
Well, those two teams were picked 1-2, South Carolina State coming away as the MEAC favorite. Norfolk State is the second best team in the preseason poll. New quarterback, Andre Lindsey, the true freshman out of Gaffney, South Carolina. So South Kakalaki getting some love here on second down. He decides to tuck it and run on the near side. And he's brought down pretty quickly thereafter.
I don't know if this is the time of game you bring him in. When Lindsey's in there, they're going to run the ball. They're going to do some wildcat. You know they're going to run. But when you're trailing 7-0, I want Quentin Williams with the football in his hands. Let him throw the rock, and I like the decision to bring him back. Now we're seeing Norfolk. This is what their scout report said they do. Man-to-man coverage. One high, man-to-man across the board. See if you can beat them one-on-one.
Williams had a man. That timing route just a little off there. Nashawn Hezekiah was the intended target, so three and out as the punting unit comes back on for the Bison.
That was the right matchup to go to. You had the one-on-one at the bottom. I think he had a little bit more time, and Williams a little bit antsy in the pocket right now. Settle down and deliver some throws. His best throws are the vertical passing game deep downfield. He has great touch on those, but he's been a little jittery in the pocket so far.
And this one continuing to bounce and roll. Down near the 25-yard line of Norfolk State, a 37-yard punt.
Good job by the defense. Norfolk State's done a good job of limiting It's a pretty good offense from Howard University, giving their offense a chance to get it going. Impressive performance by the defense in this first quarter.
Well, that was something that Dawson Odoms talked about, but he also knew that he had something special in Jawan Carter, 8 of 10 thus far, completed his last 7 passes. He's looking again, gets it away, and Justin Smith timing that perfectly as he just hung up there in the air for a little bit. Justin Smith continuing to show why he's a special receiver, always needed just the opportunity, played behind and waited behind some good guys.
And just fighting back to come back to the ball. And a few times they make Carter leave the pocket, but those are just great ball skills, going up and making that catch, getting the foot in bounds.
And that's the end of the first quarter. Norfolk State with a 7-0 advantage here at Howard. The Spartans want to keep on with their winning ways. Second quarter action is coming up, and we return.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the new Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear. Exclusively the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
The Spartans hailing from the Norfolk Hampton Roads area, about 3 hours away from Washington, D.C. You go back to the founding of this great institution back on September 18th, 1935, brought to life in the midst of the Great Depression. About 5,600 students attending there, some great programs, highly competitive nursing program, only optical engineering one, and you love to point out the notable alumni, J.B. Smoove, Tim Reed, how about Bob Dandridge, former NBA All-Star. And great run here by Lex Henry, and Henry, the former walk-on, with a good run on first down. They said they gotta just keep getting this dude reps.
And Henry's a guy, a special guy. You see the ability to turn over the change of pace back, 5'8", 175 pounds.
And Justin Smith continues to impress. Justin Smith will continue to call his name, been a favorite target of Jawan Carter throughout the season. And that's why they have one of the top passing attacks in the conference.
Coming into the game, Justin Smith had 27 catches on the season. Second place, 11. So he's gonna get the football to Justin Smith. If you're Howard, you have to key him. He's earned that respect. Make some of the supplemental receivers beat you. Don't allow Smith to just make catch after catch.
Lex Henry running off tackle and then bulldozing over the defender on his first down run. Lex Henry is picking up steam.
And this, if you're going to be a little guy, run like a little guy. Use your height or lack of height to your advantage. He's low to the ground, so when a tackler comes up high, he's already lower. Football's a game of leverage. He finished off that run.
That was a 14-yard gain, and then a quick strike to Justin Smith on first down.
And now we're starting to see the Norfolk State offense I thought we would see. They're picking them apart, gaining yards in chunks. Going a little bit more up-tempo. They know they have the bison on the ropes. They smell blood as they're in the end zone, red zone.
This group we mentioned putting up 34 points a game. Dawson Odoms wants to see his team punch it. Instead, it was Carter who was fortunate to fall on that football as he bobbled it. You just got to smile that one off.
Yeah, and here maybe just the mesh point wasn't there. Indecisive, tried to pull it. Ball came out and very fortunate to get that football because Deion Harry, number 19, was one step away from making a huge play.
Carter was a second team All-MAC selection. Hands it off to Lex Henry. Henry going hard up the paint. And he's brought down just about the 2 yard line of Howard. Deion Harry is there on the stop.
Watching Lex Henry run, he accelerates in a hurry. When he hits the gas pedal, he can get to the hole really quick. He puts a lot of pressure on the defense. I don't know if he's got the size to muscle it into the end zone. So I would think they're probably going to try and get Carter out of the pocket, maybe.
Henry's in the backfield. They elect to give it to him, and a stop there. Good play up front. It's Jevin Jackson, who we saw injured earlier, and Christian White as well, who's the QB of that defense.
Yeah, this is one where, you know, he's not going to be able to move the pile. He's a quick, the hole has to be there. Good job of stuffing the hole by Christian White. You got to kick a field goal here. Don't get it. I don't get it. You get emotional. You're up by 7. You have a chance to put a team down by 2 scores for their homecoming. Not understand why they're not kicking the field goal.
They were successful the first time, and this time they get bailed out by a penalty in the end zone.
I want to see that one, because that could have been just incidental contact on that ball there. Not sure if it's necessarily catchable, and might have been just some contact getting tripped up.
Pass interference. Defense, number 14. Half the distance to the goal. Automatic. First down.
I don't know why you go for it, though. 4th and 3. Well, this is this little inside out route.
The guilty party, Kenny Gallup. And that gives them a fresh set of downs to work with. Lex Henry remaining in the backfield, going to the right of Carter. And Carter decides to keep it himself and loses the football. Both officials signaling the touchdown. This is something they're probably going to review, Jay.
Yeah, it's a score, so they will, but the problem is assuming that he lost control of the football well after he was in the end zone. All you have to do is break the plane with control of the football. This will be interesting to see if we have a look that says anything different.
Whoa! See? It looked like it was punched out right before
as
he was crossing the plane from that angle. Here's another look here.
That
ball comes out just before, from my naked eye, but I know the replay officials will have another look at it. Now, I think it was Christian White again coming up from behind to try to dislodge that ball from Carter.
It is. Good job by Norfolk State even recovering the fumble as well, playing through it even though they called it a touchdown. Might have been premature. I mean, that is so close, and I don't know if we have an angle that tells us clearly he did not have the ball when he crossed the goal line. When does he cross? He was crossing from the angle he had.
Right.
Had he crossed the goal line, say no. Looks like I would say no. I'd say that ball's out.
I'm in agreement with you that it did not look like he crossed the plane. It looked like he lost it just about right here. Yeah. So
with those fumble rules, offense can't advance that fumble, so they got to sort through some things here. Maybe not enough to overturn it there, even though he said it was controlling. This is a 50-50. If you ask me definitively, did he not have the ball? I can't say that with 100% confidence.
Right, that's why the ruling on the field is so important, because you have to have definitive evidence to prove otherwise, to show that it was not a touchdown. And based on the angles that we're seeing, I don't know if there's enough video evidence to overturn the call.
Well,
Signal, proud partner of the
Howard. We want to make sure they get this right. And so Jay Edwards still having a conversation with the replay officials in the booth. I think you also try to look at, you know, was his knee down? Right, it just comes popping out right there as Christian White.
Yeah, I think they were looking whether or not the knee was down.
Right.
We saw the knee wasn't down.
Right.
And then where did he have to throw the football when he broke the plane? He said more times than not, just have to break the plane with control of it. Just couldn't tell. We'll see what they say.
After review, it's determined that the quarterback did fumble the ball into the end zone. However, it was recovered by a Norfolk State player. Ruling of a touchdown stands.
That's what we said earlier. It was a good job of recognition by Norfolk State of recovering in the end zone. And that's so tough because you know what? Those referees blew the whistle. They blew the whistle saying touchdown. Play should stop with the whistle blowing. Jeff Woods just happened to follow up and go through it. Tough break for Howard. Tough break.
9 plays, 75 yards. And the Spartans up by 2 scores. Well, Jawan Carter helping to put his team further ahead of the Bison here at Howard.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes 1 coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
ESPN, home of the college football playoff.
Run it.
Back here at Howard, let's talk a little bit about near the way, right? Navy is in action hosting the second-ranked Bearcats of Cincinnati, and Cincinnati is in a tight one with the midshipmen, 13-10 at the half.
Wow, up the road in Annapolis, huh? Mm-hmm. No, you had a chance to see the midshipmen play today. You see that coming?
I did not see that coming. PT Dub. McDonald on the return, and McDonald, who is screened all the way and met by a number of white jerseys. We're on the campus of Howard University, and Larry Scott talking about why he wanted to be here, the great legacy, the tradition that has been established over the years, 1867 when it was founded, just under 10,000 students and a number of notable alums. I'm sitting next to one, by the way, and Jay Skywalker, but Kamala Harris, Chadwick Boseman, Thurgood Marshall are some of the names that pop off the page.
And thought the university did a good job renaming the School of Fine Arts the Chadwick Boseman School of Fine Arts. Classy move by the alma mater.
Great endowment, also established in his name. Kevin Cole. Flick says there's a penalty marker on the play.
Number 21, Brandon Savage, but there are flag on the play.
There is no foul. The contact was deemed legal.
They pick up the flag. important time right now. I mean, Norfolk State is established. That offense is going to score points. You know, we talked about the number of points they've scored during the last 4 weeks. They're going to get it in the 40s. Can Howard keep up? Are they ready for a track meet? Here right now, and this is where Quinn Williams realizes the situation. You're down by 14. You can't put your defense back on the field. The Bison need to get it going.
Williams, who was looking for Matthew McDonald, the pass incomplete, still will bring up third and short.
He's off. Williams isn't hitting. I mean, you talk about McDonald was open for a long time. Right? As he's rolling the pocket, get him the football. He's holding it an extra step. That ball's not even close. On a quick sprint out rollout, that's an easy completion there. Williams just has to settle down and start making some throws to give his offense a chance.
Not been able to convert on third down so far today, but changing that is Jaron Hunter, and Hunter with a strong run across the 45 before he's tripped up. Jaron Hunter showing some life, 19 yards on that run.
And this is great running. And to be a good runner, you have to make people miss in small spaces. So after he gets by the initial line of scrimmage, watch him size up number 28, the safety. Puts him in the box, makes one hard cut. R.J. Cole took a poor angle. He made him pay, getting more yardage on that run.
That sets up the Bison. They give it back to 22 and blue again. That's Jaron Hunter across midfield, tripped up and brought down here. The 46.
Hunter back-to-back impressive runs. The offensive line may be starting to gain control against this huge defensive line from Norfolk State.
That offensive line has done well thus far. You think about Darius Fox, Jamal Hines, both two true freshmen at the guard positions. This time, change of pace, the speed, the burst. Ian Wheeler keeping it going, moving the Bison headed in the right direction. R.J. Coles has been busy the last three plays.
Yeah, Fox and Doc over on the left side do a good job of giving him a cutback lane. If you look at number 79, Doc, his best football's ahead of him. 6'8", 355-pound left tackle from Toronto, Canada, still learning how to play the game. He's a one-on-one matchup.
Quentin Williams decides to keep it himself and catching the Spartan defense off guard. So continuing to see success on the ground.
And when the offense isn't quite getting it done in the air, use your legs and the running backs. And Quentin Williams with a good job on the zone read, calls his own number, picks up another first down as Howard is in the red zone.
Gain of 16 for Williams. Looking to answer right back. You talked about how critical of a time that was, and maybe that got Williams going. Finding Casey Hawthorne for 4 yards.
R.J. Cole. Norfolk State playing man-to-man coverage. You're in the red zone. They're doing that to help get another body in the box to stop the run. Find some crossing routes. Get a little rub route. Route where the receiver has the ability to run away from the defensive back.
Williams going to the outside, looking for Antoine Murray, and it's intercepted in the end zone. Justin Toller, who had a couple of INTs a few weeks ago against Hampton, comes up with a big pick here.
Great play. In anticipation, it's almost like he knew they were going to try him. Bump and run coverage. As a quarterback, you don't like to settle for throwing fade routes. You want routes where they're running away from people, and you'll see the recognition. He was all over it. Big play from Toller here at homecoming for Howard University.
Justin Toller coming up with the pick in the end zone. And just when you thought Howard was driving and putting something together to try to answer, they hand it right back over.
What do we say in the open? When he's really good, this offense is really good. But when he's bad, they're bad. And we've seen that now. Yet to put a point on the board. That's just one where you have to know how to play the position a little bit better.
Carter rolling out of the pocket and then pushed out of bounds by Broken Burr.
Carter on the keeper.
And this has to be frustrating, defending Carter, because as a defensive lineman, you want to get to him. And this offensive line, obviously, they take pride in not letting Carter get touched. And then when you do get there, he's going to take off and run. And then when you start looking in the backfield, he's going to complete a pass behind your linebackers or deep downfield with his poise and progressions.
Well, this is the test that Howard was expecting this weekend thus far, trailing by two touchdowns. They've got to come up with the stop here as they bottle up J.J. Davis.
This is where you would normally like your chances. Third and long, third and seven plus. If you can get a stop, but getting stops against Jawan Carter is not easy. But I think it's time to leave your comfort zone. If your defensive coordinator, Troy Douglas, dial up a blitz. Go chase him down. You can't allow him to sit comfortably in the pocket. Bring pressure. It's coming.
He gets it away. The pass is complete, but short of the first down marker as Ellington comes up with the grab. So the blitz leaves him a yard short after that completion.
Yeah, just a little bit late getting there, and a good quarterback recognizes when he's bringing pressure, and they were able to force the fourth down barely.
Troy Douglas said it doesn't matter how you get it done as long as you get it done. Remember, he gave his group Krispy Kreme donuts for that shutout victory a couple of weeks back.
Donuts for the donut.
Yeah. Yeah, but we talked about you got to have that fresh sign on. Got to be hot.
It is
we'll see if the bison come in hot on this.
Back coverage. Come back with us.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
Washington, D.C., about 64 degrees, about overcast. The Howard University cheerleaders. And how about the Showtime marching band sporting off their new uniforms?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Showtime.
We'll get a chance to see them at the half. You can catch it on ESPN 3 seed uninterrupted. Larry Scott trying to figure things out. We talked to him about homecoming week and the pressures of that. And how do you keep your players focused? He said, look, let me just say that we have to focus on the process. But he was also curious to see how his group would respond to that little taste of success that they had been experiencing, especially after that bye week. Getting some time off. Instead, they go for it on fourth and one, the fake punt. And Norfolk State gets it, and Moore catching everybody off guard. The coach is right next to us. They're smiling. They're happy for Norfolk.
Who is this dude? Dawson Nolans, I've known you for a while, and you are a defensive coordinator. And defensive coordinators normally want to control the clock, ball possession, going for a fake punt on fourth down, backed up on your own 20. Who is he?
Well, that dude was Ryan Richter, who ran the ball. Meanwhile, Dawson Nolan's trying to tell you he's reformed. He's different now that he's moved from the SWAC to the MEAC.
You can teach an old dog new tricks, I guess.
Hey, look, we saw him dapper as ever before the game, feeling good and like new money down in Norfolk.
What a call. I mean, you have to think about it. If you don't convert on that, you're giving Howard offense a chance to get some points automatically right away, going to your lead. But he must have seen something, and that's where you give credit to your coaching and your scouting. If we get this look, we can execute this play and have the courage to call the play in a real life situation.
Carter. And on the outside, that's the tight end, Anthony Williams. First time he's been targeted. He's another one of those receivers who's helped to open up that passing game for Carter.
Is Juwan Carter the coolest quarterback we've seen play this year? I mean, when you say cool, you know, and I watch him on film, and when you watch the film, it doesn't really, it shows how quickly he runs the ball, makes decisions, but he's so calm, cool, collected in the pocket, like nothing flusters this quarterback.
Well, that's the advantage of having a fifth-year senior, a guy who is familiar with this system, comfortable even though with the coaching change. Offensive coordinator B.T. Sherman was retained and there, wrapped up. And good defensive hold there as Deion Harry coming in to make the stop.
On the tackle.
I mean, besides, you have to wonder, maybe better off handing the ball off to J.J. Davis rather than calling your own number. Great individual play by Deion Harry, able to track down Carter, prevent him from getting the yardage for the first down.
Okay, Jay, I'm anticipating that we will see a punt here on fourth and two. Richie LaRaza standing at his own 20.
Shanks.
Out of bounds, so he's spotted just near the 27 or 8-yard line, or better than that. Howard will get the ball when we come back.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively the Home Depot.
Ooh, la la.
They'll be coming up at the half, a long time with the Showtime marching band from Howard University. You can catch it uninterrupted on the ESPN app to check out the complete show. It's starting to fill up even more because, you know, halftime is just over 4 minutes away. So you know what that means. I know you always like to say we're here to see the football.
Absolutely.
And all that good stuff. However, comma. The bands also mean something here too as well.
Part of culture. You mentioned the new band uniform for Howard University. Look, crisp.
Crisp. I like that. Meanwhile, Howard has looked crisp on the ground. I mean, they run the ball well. Now they've just got to get Quinton Williams going. Jared Hunter has been a big part of that success on the ground. A gain of about a couple for the sophomore.
And it's almost like Quinton Williams needs to get out of the way. And you don't want to say that about your quarterback, but the running game has been there. And he hasn't made the easy throws, which has made things a lot more difficult. But I will say this, the moment you decide you're going to take the run away from Howard, Williams will hurt you with a deep ball downfield. He's a very good downfield passer.
We'll decide to hand it off once more. Well, we talked about Williams in the open and the importance. They go as he goes. If you're Larry Scott and Lee Holland, you're saying, well, what adjustments do we need to make? How can we get, you know, our struggling QB moving? What do you do?
You do what he likes. And I think in this case, he's not going to have a high percentage tonight. So have him go 11 for 30, but those 11 completions are for 20 yards or more.
That's complete underneath. That's Casey Hawthorne. And something just real simple turns into a little bit more. We saw that on that school record touchdown pass that he threw to Antoine Murray back against Morgan State.
Yeah, this is the drive route. Threw it just right in front of him. Not really a great thrown ball right there, but more of a good adjustment by Hawthorne. But you need somebody to be a spark. I mean, It's homecoming. You got a large crowd here. You want to show out for mama and them on homecoming, and your homeboys that are watching. Give me a chance to make a play.
You know, all your cousins and all that good stuff. Quentin Williams feeling the pressure, trying to get out the pocket, was able to do so, and then scampers out of bounds near the 40. So good decision there by Williams to keep it.
Live to fight another day. And I like the mix up here, but I like how Hawthorne was showing. He's got a little spark. Hawthorne, he knows what it's about. He's trying to do something number three. Still think 18, McDonald's an underutilized weapon for them. 6 foot 5 inch wide receiver that can move.
Just under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Williams with the pass complete. And he connects with Hawthorne again. So Casey Hawthorne is being that playmaker they need here on this drive.
Yeah, you'll see the throw there. Kind of babies the ball a little bit. Good job of Hawthorne getting that knee off the ground. Pick up some more yardage. First down for the Bison.
Williams with time going on the outside. You talked about the big frame of McDonald. He was targeting the 6'5" senior there, but just a little off of the time.
Yeah, and the rhythm. He's not there. He was late with that ball. I mean, you know, McDonald was open for a long time by himself, and he actually allowed the defensive back to come back into the play. Just the rhythm there. You got to let that ball go. You got it on the 30, 28-yard line. You're making a shot to the end zone. It's got to come out on time.
Williams taking the easy pass underneath again. And it's complete gain of 60, Antoine Murray. Timeout taken by Howard. Well, Jay gives us a great time to set up your power rankings for this weekend. How do you see it?
It's been interesting. A lot of shakeup a little bit from what we've got. I told everybody beginning of the year, Alcorn's going to be heard from. You know, they're the defending champions of the SWAC from 2019. Fred McNair has the Braves playing great football. Florida A&M, I'm going FAMU because I honestly think at certain points FAMU may be the number one or number two team in HBCU football. After that one-point loss to Jackson State, Willie Simmons has them playing well. Norfolk State, you're seeing them here. Man, I know what I'm talking about, don't I?
Oh,
I was like the first guy to put Norfolk in the top five out there, proving it right. They got a quarterback. We're seeing a defense. They're legit. Prairie View A&M, solid resume. Eric Dooley doing his best job of coaching since he's been there. And the number one team is Jackson State University. Deion Sanders has them playing football at a high level down in Jackson, Mississippi.
And we were talking about making sure that the Tigers don't trip up against the Wildcats, who are searching for their first win of the season. Meanwhile, that Prairie View Southern game coming up later tonight, you can catch it on the ESPN app. 7 p.m. Casey Hawthorne, nice way to haul that one in.
Comes down to that spot. It's going to be short of spot. Decision time here. I think you go for it in this situation here. They're going to take points.
Take points because they've been hard to come by thus far in the first half, and so they will trot on Raji Woodson, their field goal kicker, a senior out of Greensboro, North Carolina. 2 for 2 on the season.
I thought it was 4th and 1. It's actually 4th and 3. Take your points.
The 36-yarder against Morgan State, this one from 38. And it's up and in. So Woodson gets the Bison on the board before heading into the locker room. Under a minute to go. And sometimes you just need to see that goose egg erased.
Absolutely, and get any points you can and try and take any type of momentum you can into the locker room. And if you're Howard, you're going to say, hey, we went down there, we moved the ball, we put points on them to end the half. Let's do more of that to start the second half. Norfolk State, I think they had a couple missed opportunities to really bury Howard. Howard's had to be lucky just to be able to hang around.
And this is the scene. you love to see it. We were walking on the yard yesterday, Jay, and just checking out just what the vibe and what the feel is. And it's always good when you come back home to the Mecca, huh?
It is. It is. Haven't called a homecoming game here in probably 15 years or so. And all the events, and it's a different homecoming this year, obviously, because of what's taking place in America, but slowly starting to get back to where we were. Howard homecoming still is Howard homecoming. What about, it's always going to be a surprise, right? So the surprise was they had a surprise concert by Wale.
Yeah, he dropped his second album, another album here on homecoming weekend. Kevin Johnson on the return. And we were standing just nearby when they made that announcement, and the students went like crazy.
Yeah.
They were like, yeah, you know, falling out, I'm sure.
Yeah, you know, Wale's from the DMV area there, dropping an album. And I remember when I was here, I was talking to my good friend AJ Calloway last night about seeing the Fugees get booed here at Howard Homecoming when they first came out. But we also talked about Mary J. Blige rocking the house for Howard Homecoming, Notorious B.I.G.
Did you just name drop AJ?
That's
from
homeboy.
The legendary, you know, 106 in Park.
We were on the yard together.
Everybody knows AJ. Here's Cameron Bryant. Excuse me, Brent. And Cameron Brent, one of those physical backs, good for 15 yards up the middle. And if you're Norfolk State,
if you get another run like that, you step on the gas pedal.
The exchange there between Carter and Brent, not as clean, but still two timeouts remaining for Norfolk State and Howard. And it looks like Norfolk State is gonna be content.
I wonder who was more popular on the yard.
Mm-hmm.
When we were here on the yard, like you always say during your era. So folks out of my era were Diddy,
uh-huh,
when they first got here. Then you had Shy, the music group.
And if I
AJ.
Ever
AJ Calloway.
Mm-hmm.
Nanda Lewis. And who I think is the most popular now outside of Diddy, Ta-Nehisi Coates.
Yeah, I'm going to go with Diddy. And that's the end of the first half. 14-3 advantage for the visitors in their MEAC opener. Norfolk State with a 14-3 advantage. But it's homecoming season in D.C. Spartans looking strong.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the new Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
When it comes to college football Saturdays, predominantly white and historically black institutions have a few things in common. Both feature tailgating, and both highlight marching bands. But this is where the similarities end. At large schools with big-time programs, football is the major commodity, the undisputed center of attention. Black college football has great players and outstanding competition as well.
Down the middle, what a strike.
Here he is, in the open. Yes, he's in.
But at HBCUs, football is more likely to be background music for reunions and reconnections. The roots of these reunions go back to planter-sponsored plantation festivals, which families that had been sold off and separated used as an excuse to reconnect with loved ones. As a student athlete at Morgan State University, I was enveloped by an atmosphere of love and togetherness each fall Saturday afternoon. From socializing in the stands to watching high-stepping bands, black fraternities and sororities execute high-energy step shows. Football Saturdays at HBCUs are a microcosm of black culture. Like the schools themselves, HBCU football tells a poignant, sometimes painful story of our nation's history. against fierce white opposition, these institutions were created after the Civil War to educate and elevate formerly enslaved African Americans. Between 1866 and 1872, more than 20,000 people were killed because of this fear of black education. Some schools were burned down, some teachers run off or murdered. Yet, these institutions survived. Each HBCU Football Saturday is a celebration of their survival. Throughout the 1930s, 40s, and 50s, black colleges were the only place most aspiring black students could attend. This included gifted football players. By the mid-1970s, predominantly white institutions, especially those in the South, had actively begun to recruit black athletes.
Bo Jackson breaks tackle, three tackles, he's gone!
By the 1980s, major programs throughout the country relied on black players to bring glory and revenue to the university. Deion Sanders went to Florida State. Tyrone Wheatley went to Michigan. Eddie George went to Ohio State.
Gets away! George is gone! Eddie George putting up more Heisman Trophy numbers!
Now, even with the blue chip talent going to predominantly white institutions, HBCUs persevere and continue to provide opportunities for African Americans to use athletics to earn a degree. These schools have also given accomplished professionals like Sanders, Wheatley, and George an opportunity to get head coaching jobs they could not get at their respective alma maters.
We're trying to provoke change 100%. Everything we do, we're pushing the envelope, trying to take things to another level.
For students who attend historically black colleges, Football Saturdays are more than a celebration of the game, but a celebration of each other. They are an unfettered celebration of black love.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
Time here at Green Stadium. The Showtime Marching Band of Howard University paying tribute and salute to General Colin Powell, who we lost earlier this week. Back with more after the break.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant.
You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Miss Howard and her homecoming court here at Green Stadium, and you see the wave. You gotta get that patent wave down if you want to be a part of the Royal Court.
14-3. Show me the wave.
Wait a minute, let me see.
You do the wave, Tiff. They're taking their time with the wave.
You do. You have to be deliberate and slow about
it. So
you
were the queen of orange and green.
That's right. That's right. And
that's
so you had to practice this. You kind of got to cut the hand a little bit.
If I were the guy, I'd be like, what's up?
That's what they kind of do. You know, they kind of do the.
All right.
You know, whatever. All right. So, you know, as we always do at this time, it's time for Jay's Gimme Five.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
This is the Gimme Five show.
Perfect right now. Look at that Howard uniform. Look at that Howard uniform looking clean, spiral, the mobility, all the other good stuff that goes along with it. But how about this? The five greatest HBCU tight ends. For the first time ever, I got myself in a jam, Tim. So, Shanko went to Morgan State, also played for the New York Giants, got a Super Bowl there with Manning. He was a good one there, but who's also number five?
You tell me.
Could have been a tie there, but I'm going with Jimmy Johnson from Howard University here. A lot of people don't know about Jimmy. Option tight end, but was a special type of talent. Could really get the ball downfield, play for the Washington football team. Number three, Raymond Chester, one of the all-time greats from Morgan State University. People know about Raymond Chester, not only in college at Morgan, but also in the National Football League. Number two, I'm going with my old teammate from the New England Patriots that went to Livingston College. And one thing about Ben Coates is he could flat out play. He should be in the Pro Football Hall of Fame, considering what he did at Livingston. And number one, the number one tight end, if you don't think he's number one, I think he'll tell you he's number one. And if you question him being number one, I don't think you want to deal with that heat. Who's number one, Tiff?
Shannon Sharp.
Shannon Sharp.
He wants all the smoke.
Savannah State University. Hey, he was a force down there when they had a good squad there at Savannah State there. So that's my Gimme Five. On the bubble, I see I'm putting my homeboy Poncho Glover, who played at Grambling. We played together in the Minnesota Vikings. He played for the Raiders. And Big Six, I see it. Marcus Hinton, when he was a wide receiver at Alcorn for Steve McNair, turned, got to tease him, ate himself into a tight end in the National Football League. But Marcus Hinton, that's my Gimme Five. Want to talk about it? Hit us up online. You know where to get us on social media, Black College Live. But remember, it's Jay's Gimme Five.
Well, Tiff's Two Cents, Chad Fan, how about from Florida A&M University, Rick Caster from Jackson State. Don't hate if you want to. It's okay, though. 14-3 from the half of Howard Homecoming. Oh, yeah.
Waiting till they see the strength and hear the win. It's Black College Live. I'ma need five on it. If they put overtime on it.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty bank color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
Got the first half, some key plays for you. Going for it on fourth down. Interesting decision there by Dawson Odoms, but it paid off.
They tried to set the tone early, and Justin Smith came up with a huge fourth down grab. They capped off the drive with a touchdown to Daquan Felton to give the Spartans early lead.
Meanwhile, they were able to put the ball back into the end zone, aided by a pass interference penalty, and then questionable here, but they say Juwan Carter was able to break the play.
Yep, and they came up with a recovery in the end zone as well. They gave a 14-point lead. It was all things normal, but Howard University able to mount a drive at the end of the half to put some points on the scoreboard. And that's why the score is 14-3 in favor of the green and gold.
Meanwhile, taking their walk. This is your time. It's everybody's homecoming, right? So it's important for the football team and the band and the homecoming court, SGA and the alumni as well.
It is, but it all starts with the ball. You keep trying to get me in all the other stuff. See, I'm a former player, Tiff, so I could not enjoy homecoming till after we got the win.
Right.
And then we were going to, you know, tear up the town. Then the city's yard, taking over the yard. But for the rest of you all get to celebrate and have fun.
Yeah, it's an enjoyable time. It's what you look forward to each year because we know what homecomings mean, especially throughout the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference and for HBCUs in general. So J.J. Davis returning this kickoff. Norfolk State back in that first half, did a good job under the leadership of Jawan Carter, who we look at his numbers through the air, 211 for them, but also they played pretty mistake-free football, and Dawson Odoms really likes that.
And that's the key. They didn't hurt themselves with the penalties. They didn't turn the ball over. He looked cool and calm and collected the whole first half. The key is, you're Howard, how do you rattle him? A guy like Carter that likes to have things go at his tempo and his pace, you have to figure out a way to get to him. I think they're going to have to ramp it up on defense and be a little bit more aggressive with their blitzes.
Carter taking a shot in. Justin Smith! Man. Oh my goodness! This dude just continues to make you go, wow! The ball skills, we talked about how great they were. We saw it on display in the first half, but once more, a terrific catch.
I mean, you see this, you've got two blue jerseys there, but it comes down to ball skills. And wide receivers are a little bit better at adjusting to the football than defensive backs. And he goes up to get it at its highest point.
42-yard completion to Justin Smith. Kevin Johnson on the carry right afterward. And man, just going back. Going back to that play.
I mean, he just did a good job of chasing down the ball. And he's a lot like Carter. He didn't panic when the ball was hanging in the air a long time. He went to go get it and catch it at its highest point that you're coached to do. Big play for Norfolk State here in the second half.
Quickly swing pass over to Chris Butler. Butler continuing to shake defenders. And Butler gets the Spartans back into the red zone. First time Butler has been targeted. They had so many running backs in the stable over the last few years. That's where Chris Butler lined up. They said, you know what? He's such a good athlete. We just got to keep him on the field. Johnson on the carry, runs into his own player, and maybe another defender is able to shake that off, and good for another first down run.
You know, you see the hard running here, and this is a set the tone type drive from Norfolk State. Great job by Jalen Powell, the left guard, pulling to seal to give Johnson a hole. But this is what Dawson owned. This is where you pay your coach that money. What type of adjustments are they going to make coming out of the locker room? We see Norfolk State coming out executing the plan perfectly.
Johnson with a little cut, and we thought that we would see them put their foot on the gas in the first half, and they played it a little bit conservatively, but here, now they're ready to go full throttle.
Yeah, it was like they were like wild and loose at the same time. You know, couldn't figure out what they were doing, but it was working. They never trailed in this football game. They continue to control the clock. And they're knocking on the door right now, the second and goal.
Andrew Howard player on the field that appears to be Ray Williams, starting quarterback. A junior out of Detroit is able to get off under his own power. So on second and goal, it's the Spartans who are looking up at the scoreboard and saying, we want more. Bring it on.
And this is the time where we've seen Carter get himself in trouble trying to call his own number necessarily. Give it to your running backs. Running backs love giving these touchdowns to pad their stats here. You've got Kevin Johnson in the backfield. Unless they knife down hard, hand it off on a couple of runs if you need to.
They hand the rock off to Johnson, and Johnson is able to stretch it out into the end zone. Another touchdown registered for the Spartans.
They're starting to look like the number three team in all HBCU football. And I will tell you before the game, they told me after the game, they said, we're going up to number two. They are feeling themselves right now. Norfolk, this is just speed to the edge. Good job of winning the race to the pylon by Kevin Johnson, the sophomore from Suffolk, Virginia.
And the extra point attempt is good as well. Kevin Johnson joined the team as a walk-on, had a breakout season in 2019. He's carrying it over here in 2021 for the score.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively the Home Depot.
Welcome back to ESPN College Football, presented by McDonald's. Jay Walker back home for Howard's homecoming. Norfolk State, meanwhile, spoiling the party with a 21-3 lead here in the third quarter. The look in Quentin Williams' eyes, determination, one to not be upstaged here at home for a big homecoming weekend.
You know, it's so tough because in HBCUs across the country, you got to win homecoming. Like, people that don't even care about football know if they won or lost homecoming. And it's magnified. And you have to respond and leave your best effort out there because more people are watching you during your homecoming game than any other regular season game played at home. And right now, you've got 3 points on the board.
Let me get that back to that point in just a second, Jay, but let's take a look at some of the HBCU news and notes. The South Carolina State University product, Darius Leonard, one of the top linebackers in the league. That's just what he did last week. 7 tackles, forced fumble, and an INT. Coach Prime not on the sidelines this weekend as they face off against Bethune-Cookman. Gary Harrell in as the acting Harrell coach, and the World Famous Tiger Marching Band will be performing at the Raiders game as well. When we talked to Dawson Odoms and, you know, the fact that Norfolk State was scheduled for homecoming, obviously before he got there, he said, you know what, that's a slap in the face.
It is. I mean, there's no other way around it. Everybody knows you schedule games you can win for homecoming. That's what you're trying to do, unless there's some other teams you can't play. So it was built-in bulletin board material. And they've come out and responded very effectively, scoring 21 points in this game.
Williams feeling some pressure. I'll tell you this, Deshaun Dixon had been quiet until then. The sack leader in the MEAC adds another.
You said the defense was led by the bookends, and Dixon is one of them. 6'5", 260 pounds, and finally wins that one-on-one matchup, holding the ball a little bit too long. There's Williams, donked with a left tackle, lost that battle there, but it's going to happen. When you got a talented guy like Deshaun Dixon, you just want to minimize the damage he can do.
Preseason first-team selection, Deshaun Dixon. Williams with a dangerous throw across the middle. He was eyeing Antoine Murray the entire time. And that brings up fourth down.
Just can't get it done. Give credit to Steve Adams, the defensive coordinator for Norfolk State. They have really shut down this Howard offense.
Larry Scott talking with his quarterback, just trying to figure some things out, anything that they can use as a teaching moment. That one is blocked, the block punt, and special teams coming up big. Wilson on the block punt. Recovered in the end zone by Christian Ruffin. And touchdown, Spartans.
The offense doesn't move the ball. Special teams play can be spotty. And this here, there's got to be a sense of urgency to get this punt off. But look how many white jerseys were behind the ball, and Stuart Anderson made the play.
An outstanding play from the redshirt junior, and then just scooping it up right after was Christian Ruffin. Great sequence of plays there on special teams for Norfolk State. And making Vincent Marshall, their special teams coach, smile all the more. Norfolk State making a statement here in DC.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the new Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
Stuart Anderson, who redshirted in 2017, primarily playing special teams the last two seasons, coming up big with a block punt on that last play to give Norfolk State an extension of their lead. Ian Wheeler able to shake a few tacklers before he's brought down. Return of 22. We talked about Stuart Anderson, high achiever on and off the field. Graduated with a degree last spring. Currently in the Army Reserves, a second lieutenant in the 302nd Transportation Division, and standing next to his father, Stuart Anderson Sr., who played for the Washington football team.
Won a Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. Super Bowl there with... just well-rounded. You can tell the coaches, whether it was a defensive coordinator or the head coach, they all just said positive things about Anderson, how much they respect him, and what a leader he will be in society.
False start. Offense, number 72. First down.
But you know, it gets me that they talk about all these things, like what he does off the field. Pretty good football player, too.
Yeah, yeah.
He's a better football player than they were leading us on to believe. He's had an impact in this game.
And I think it's attributed to the work ethic. You know, when we talked with Dawson Odoms, he was just like, this guy has an unbelievable work ethic. You think about, you know, him going once a month and then for 2 weeks during training to fulfill his commitment to serve our country. And on the run, and Quinn Williams is cut down quickly.
And it makes sense to have Stuart Anderson back there. He plays free safety. So you know what the free safety is in football. That's your last line of defense. Give me somebody with a military background for my last line of defense. Good luck to that young man, whatever he does in the future. And keep it up.
Second and nine, the pitch out to Wheeler. Wheeler with space, and Wheeler, who's got a burst of speed. He's got one man to beat. Tripped up near the 40-yard line by Justin Dolan.
This play works because of the play action in the backfield, but more importantly, off of number 18 in white, that's Deshaun Dixon. We talked about, we know he's a ball hog, right? He's chasing the ball. They freeze him. Thinks he's getting a sack. No, you gave up outside contain. Big play for the Bison.
32-yard gain for Wheeler. They feed him again, this time with a hole up the middle, plenty of space. And again, a nice run. Repeat of last play is Justin Toler, the tackler.
When they had success in the first half moving the ball, it was running the football. When they could get some big runs and get physical up front, now we're seeing signs of the running game coming back to life, but can they get it into the end zone? You're going to need your quarterback to make a couple runs because now Norfolk has made the adjustment and added someone into the box.
Slow down for just a second, but again, nice hard running by Wheeler. Gain of about 5. So he will get a breather and head to the sideline as Jared Hunter returns to the backfield.
I'd get the ball snapped. While they're moving around, snap the football. Your line is starting to wear them down.
They're nice doing cut. So. Nice cuts by Hunter. And Hunter, who has had a solid afternoon thus far, gets him into the red zone on that 11-yard carry.
You know, it's not sexy when you're not throwing the ball down the field, but this is good job by the offensive line. Pushing bodies through the pile. Nice running. We're starting to see they're operating as a unit offensively with that running game. The timing seems to be there for this young offensive line.
Murray in motion. This time, the pass to Murray. Murray has a little space. And he's taken down.
Disappointing there. You would think, if I get the ball to my wide receiver Murray in open field like this, this should be a tough tackle. He goes out too easy. Look, that's plenty open field space. Don't settle for the sideline. You're losing by 25 points for your homecoming. Show me you want to get into the end zone, that extra effort that's needed.
Hunter makes the cut just near the goal line, and he's just short of it. But the ground game continuing to work as the Bison moving downhill.
And that's how you run for homecoming when you're trailing. Hall wasn't there initially. Hunter kept his legs going, made a cut. You can see the will to try and get to the end zone. Let me take a look. It's not there. Lower your shoulder pad level. Take him for a ride. Do everything you can to get in to help your football team.
Williams under center, going to try to sneak it in. And does he get in? The signal saying is just short.
Quinn Williams is 6'4". About 170. He's not moving the pile. I don't like QB sneak with him down there. I like QB sneaks when you got the quarterbacks 200 pounds plus, 180. You get up underneath his shoulder pads. He's not going anywhere. He can't push through that. Even though that was real close.
That was real close. They're going to try it again, perhaps. And this time, Quentin Williams is successful.
Uh-oh.
But a penalty marker is out. On the far side, Jay. Meanwhile, Norfolk State players slow to get up, and I think that was Deshaun Dixon. So Williams able to punch it in. First TD of the day for Howard.
Able to get the pad level lower. Nervous at the beginning of the play because he seemed to be high, but able to dip low just enough to get to the end zone. And Howard with a much needed touchdown here for their homecoming.
Well, that was all set up by the great ground game as I think they're gonna have a quick review of that last play to make sure it was a touchdown. And from all indications,
should be quick.
You put your timer on.
Wow.
Wow. After review.
Pretty good look from our camera crew there down in the trenches. You see how close things can be. Somewhere in that pile is Quentin Williams, able to get the ball across the goal line.
Woods it on for the extra point. Well, good luck and drive put together by Howard. Success on the ground. Capped off by a little dip, baby, dip. That's Quinn Williams tipping on into the end zone.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the new Bear Dynasty bank color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear. Exclusively the Home Depot.
Still plenty of football left to play here, and Howard trimming the lead to just 3 scores after that Quinton Williams quarterback sneak.
Now it's time for the defense to make a stop. See, the band will get you into it. You like that.
Yes, I do.
And I will tell you, I was one of those emotional players. Like, I was always thinking, man, I want to strike up the band. The band would get me going whenever they showed up. So now you need something to build some momentum defensively. Problem is, MEAC Offensive Preseason Player of the Year Juwan Carter on the other sideline for Dawson Odoms. They've not been able to slow down this Spartan offense.
Yeah, Jay, when you look at the way Carter has played throughout this season, especially during this 4-game winning streak for the Spartans, I mean, he's one of the top players in all of HBCU football.
And he's starting to feel it. Football team that hasn't lost a game to an FCS opponent in a long time.
Kevin Johnson says it. I'm feeling it too. But some laundry comes out there. On the return.
Holding, return team number 37. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down, Norfolk State.
What's that type of swagger you start to feel and pick up as a quarterback when you know you're playing well? I mean, kind of what's running through your mind from play to play?
Yeah. Coach, hurry up and call the play. I'm on fire. I don't care what you call. You can call anything in the playbook. I'm going to make it work. Let's get it going. Let's keep them on the ropes. Carter, Norfolk State is the number one pass efficient offense in the MEAC. They're number 9 in the country, and you see why. The decisions, the fact that Carter just does not get rattled.
Well, again, we've seen a stable of running backs. Yeah. He's been able to hand it off to Kevin Johnson, Cameron Britt on that last carry, J.J. Davis, Lex Henry. I mean, the spoil of riches there in the backfield that helped to complement Carter.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to play running back in Norfolk State because you're going to share time, but they believe in next man up. And just when you start thinking J.J. Davis is the guy, then it was Kevin Johnson. Now we're seeing Brenton. Brenton brings a little extra pep in his step to the game.
Physical runner, likes to be on the interior, doesn't mind that type of contact. 5'8", 200 pounds.
Fifth-year senior with an opportunity to play here in front of the world's best homecoming crowd.
Jay, I think that's debatable. I think that's debatable. I know you like to try to throw that out there and, you know, drop those little nuggets per your perspective. However, I got something to say about that, and I'm sure Southern has something to say about that. They got homecoming this weekend, Delaware State.
The world's most famous homecoming.
Florida A&M's homecoming next weekend. Good stop and stuff there by Ray Williams. Quickly meeting Lex Henry at the point of attack.
And that's the aggressive nature you have to have. Ray Williams plays nickel back for Howard. So that means they were bringing him in there on a run-stopping blitz to be some type of disruptor, whether it was run or pass. He got the tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Now they need him in coverage. So he plays at nickel. So he's lined up against Justin Smith, the number one target for Carter.
Justin Smith, that's just impressive. There he is. He gets behind. And just that little nook and cranny that he found and able to come up with a completion.
They're trying to play zone coverage, and Justin Smith is a slot receiver. He's going to come across formation. You see him there. He's going to leave your screen untouched, free release route for the number one target. That's not a recipe for success defensively.
And Smith appears to be a little banged up after that play. Another 100-yard game for him as that play is also under review.
Yeah, a little bit more accurate throw, and I think Smith is able to run for a lot of yards after the catch. That ball didn't move. That's catch. It hurt him.
Yeah.
I mean, he went down on the turf, but good job of getting his hands underneath it. Ball doesn't move. But more importantly, as you mentioned, Smith left favoring that shoulder. You see the contact as he went down to the ground.
Six receptions, 126 yards for the fifth-year senior out of Richmond, Justin Smith. He's been slow during his career. We talked about him having to wait his turn for opportunities, but he's also been hampered by injuries for the last several seasons.
And I know Carter wishes he could have that back, because if you lead Smith up the field, he's running up the hash mark into the end zone. Instead, they'll probably just have to settle for a long completion. That is actually a really good job of securing that ball, not allowing it to move on the turf.
Just look at what he's able to do as he's waving, saying, maybe I'm all right. I'm all good.
After review, the ruling on the field of a completed catch and a first down is confirmed. First down, Norfolk.
And they're certainly hoping that he can be healthy and return, because in order for Norfolk State to capture their first MEAC title with a 2011 season vacated because of wins, and hoping that he can be a part of that moving forward.
You see that 15 straight completions from Carter. Ask him what it's like to be in the zone.
Right.
He's like I was back in the day. Just call any play. I'm going to make it work.
Jay-Z said, like the home 2-3. How about Lex Henry? Flip those numbers around. 3-2.
Lex Henry on the
flag. Near the 40, likely to come back.
Holding, offense, number 74. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot remains. First down.
I want to see this. And the only reason why, like, how do you call holding on a run play? Unless you're allowed to take a guy down. It's not pass protection, so I'm curious. The center, Kobe Bird, called for the hold. He's playing center right there, middle of your screen. Get out of here. Come on, man. Come on, man. I knew something. If you're going to call hold on running plays, it's got to be obvious in my book.
There's DeKendall James, the Coastal Carolina transfer. The team high 37 catches back in that 2019 season. Thus far, a little bit slower going with his completions this year. Second and 14.
That last one, that was 16? Completion number 16?
That was completion number 16.
I mean, just tallying them up. Look at all the soft coverage that they're playing.
Carter, right now, just having a field day. Tremaine Talbert. Another target. So he's spreading the wealth. Not only is he completing passes, he's getting everybody involved.
17 throws in a row, and give credit to the line. There is no pass rush. He's able to go through all of his progressions, not really having to run. And we talked about the dual threat, his legs. Well, he's picking them apart from the pocket.
Four wide receivers, three to the top of your screen.
You got to change what you're doing. I mean, your two or three man rush isn't doing it. Bring an extra guy, admit that we can't get to him.
Going to Talbert again, his former high school teammate from Highland Springs in Richmond. And once again, the connection.
Yeah, this is long throw, all the way across field. That's why the ball is dying a little bit. That's a tough throw to make from one hash mark all the way to the other sideline. But I just defensively, I don't know what Howard is trying to do. They're playing soft zone coverage. They know the pass rush can't get to them. Get up in these receivers' faces. You're giving them free releases, and they are killing you.
Lex Henry on the carry and the stop after about a gain of one. That was Aaron Walker coming up from his linebacker position.
How many times has Howard even touched Juwan Carter?
Not many, if at all.
No sacks.
No.
No sack. I'm just talking about pressures, hurries. There's been nothing.
Well, that's been special about this O-line, that they've been able to keep Juwan Carter upright for most of the season. I mean, they've only allowed seven sacks on the year through six games.
Upright is one thing. Untouched, that's remarkable.
Talbert again.
You know, I'm going to say it. I am having fun watching him pick apart this defense. I don't care about the opponent.
Spoken like a true quarterback.
Playing quarterback, I mean, it's almost like if you have to run, your offensive line is going to be mad at you. They're probably going to say, where you going, man? I had my guy. He's just having fun out there playing 7-on-7 right now at an FCS level defense.
Third and four from the Howard 25. And spending the timeout is Norfolk State.
It is their first of the half. It will be 30 seconds.
Well, Dawson Odoms is trying to restore the winning ways of a guy by the name of William Dick Price, one of the most successful coach in Norfolk State history, as we always like to pay tribute to the legends in the game.
Exactly. I mean, you see the CIAA championships and coached some really good football players there when he had his run at Norfolk State, and, you know, the old school ways. He was AD, track coach, probably had to clean the locker room, stuff like that, all love. So, Coach Price, thank you for your contributions to HBCU football, particularly the CIAA.
Yeah, I mean, like, Coach Price did his thing. Like, he won a pair of D2 national championships in track and field around that same time, three consecutive CIAA titles in the 70s. He even coached, what's the dude's name, the Olympic gold medalist, Stephen Riddick.
Stephen Riddick and Coach, our good friend Willie Gillis, who was a quarterback for him down there. Gillis had a little shot, a cup of coffee in the NFL.
Carter, 19 straight completions for Juwan Carter.
And he owes Chris Butler a hand for that one, because Butler was well covered. And a less sure-handed wide receiver does not make that catch in traffic. And I like that. Carter going over to him. Yeah, boy, he knows. That was a tight window for that completion, and he got it done.
End of the third quarter. And Norfolk State looking to be in complete control here, up by three scores. It's because we've seen some outstanding plays on offense, special teams as well. Sparks hype, behold the green and gold.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
The nation's capital through three quarters, 28-10 advantage for Norfolk State. Winners of four straight coming into their MEAC opener on the road. Jay Walker, Tiffany Green with you.
Come on, Tiff, give it to me now. Quarterback play like we're
Juwan
seeing right now.
Carter. What? You know what? I like to say, Juwan, I got to keep balling Carter.
Yes.
Okay, and that's what he is doing right now.
He's having fun right here smiling, but.
Yeah, he's giving you everything.
School record, 20 consecutive completions, and we're watching him make history.
You got to love it.
Been fun to watch. He's been efficient with it, picking them apart. 21.
Where's 21 Savage for me right now? Give me a little something. You know, just a significant number. What was that?
It's a football game. I know, it's a football game. I'm watching 21 straight completions right now. And you want to talk about 21 Savage.
Yeah. I mean, because, like, you being a savage right now with 21 completions. So it actually kind of works in its own weird little way.
Let's see if he gets deuce, number 22.
See, you're following me. You're following me, Jay. The handoff to Henry and Brokenberg on the stop. So that'll bring up third down.
That's hard. I mean, you almost wish, if you're Howard, you wish it was like third and two. Because now it's third and four, and they're going to throw Carter at you. Carter's going to pick a poison. And one good thing, he does not have Justin Smith available to him. We've not seen Smith come back in the game. So who's going to be the guy to step up for Norfolk State in the passing game?
You got Daquan Felton to the bottom of your screen. His good teammate, Tremaine Talbert, in the slot.
Howard finally moves up to defensive backs to stop giving the wide receivers free release.
With time, looking for a man in the end zone, and that's broken up. So the streak is stopped right there as Kenny Gallup on the BBU.
Good job. That was a matchup that you wanted. You had your tight end against your strong safety, trying to go to Anthony Williams. He actually manages to get behind Gallup, but the streak comes to an end on a throw into the end zone.
So a 31-yard attempt for Josh Nardone as Juwan Carter's like, it's okay. Let me keep seeing points registered on that board. Nardone holds up his end of the bargain. 31-10, an outstanding performance for Juwan Carter. 21 straight completions for that young man.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. We're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come, like Stainmaster with lifetime stain resistance limited warranty. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
ESPN College Football is presented by McDonald's Black and Positively Golden Movement, elevating the next generation of Black excellence.
Get it. You know, that's part of the thing. You got an egg You know, everybody on Showtime marching band in the stands. Hey, how y'all doing?
I mean, to think like the future leaders of America are part of that picture you're seeing there, the Howard Band. That's at every HBCU you go to, you know.
Ian Wheeler is not at every HBCU, but he's at Howard, ladies and gentlemen, on the return. But a flag came out on this outstanding return from Wheeler.
It's going to come down to that penalty, and unfortunately, when you see yellow laundry on the field at the 50-yard line, it's normally for a hold or something against the return team.
Well, you could just see the body language of the Howard players near where that flag was thrown.
There is no foul.
Oh!
Contact was deemed legal.
Oh!
Result of the play, touchdown.
96-yard kickoff return for a touchdown.
You smell that? Smell that home cooking? They picked up the flag. It's happened. We'll see it on the top of your screen as he's going out to the left. They were engaged there through the conversation. Clearly a flag thrown. They talked it out. And I just saw two players that were tangled up as well. I thought it would have been a tough call to do. But special teams comes through the play for Howard.
Ian Wheeler, representing H-Town, coming down from Bikini on the ground. So that energizes the crowd, and now Howard going for the two-point conversion. Make it a two-score game, but before we do, looks to be a stoppage in play. I think a timeout taken on the field.
I'm curious as to why you go for two in this situation here. Down by 15, kick you at the point becomes 14. That's two touchdowns. Two PATs. If you miss, I'm always like, if you miss,
right,
then you know you're going to have to get a two-point conversion at some point. You know it. So I think you take points here.
And now we're seeing Faraji Woodson trotting out.
If you need that two-point play that you think you saw, that you worked on, then you can use it later in the game if needed.
This one up and good. Larry Scott says he loves the persistence of his team, the fight that they have shown, and they're continuing to show that here today. Ian Wheeler, 96-yard kickoff touchdown return for TD.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the new Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Just as the cameras come back here to Green Stadium and the band was playing, the Men of Omega Sci-Fi were hopping. That's like their spot there in the end zone.
Yeah, you got different spots here, different locations. Alpha chapter of Omega Sci-Fi Incorporated here at the Mecca. Cues run deep here now.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to say that. So do those signals.
Yeah, we got a chance
to see the Alpha. Them cabins run deep here, too. Greek life is real big here on the yard. I mean, depending on that's how, man. You're going to get suspended. You're going to have something. I'm going to be there.
Oh, that's a cross
line. I'm not lying. Yeah, but I hear they will suspend your line in a minute.
Like, yeah, we were running through, like, okay, how you know what was going on at the time and who was running the yard was based on who was actually the yard.
Yeah.
Who's that? Because we're like, who was that? Nah, they were suspended. No, they didn't come back till I graduated.
But I tell all them Greeks, ball squad always active. Ball squad always active on this yard.
Well, now that they've had some meaningful games like they have here today, tied for first in the MEAC, J.J. Davis with the return. Time now for our college football look ahead, brought to you by McDonald's. Some important games you'll want to circle and you go to that bottom row because we'll be in Birmingham for the Magic City Classic.
The Magic City Classic. Mm-hmm. You got to hype your voice up, Tiff. What game is that? It's the Magic City Classic.
See, that's why I got you. That's why we play off of we
number
yin and
one,
yang.
The number one classic in the country. I said
yes, it is.
I've said it on record. It is.
It is. Alcorn State and Southern as well. Meanwhile, Norfolk State, got to make sure they don't have a track game next week if they can
first
pull
Morgan
out
State.
Of victory.
That would be the biggest upset.
Hey, look, remember they did it to North Carolina A&T a couple years back to completion coming out of the break, and that's Juwan Carter to Justin Smith, and he loses the football. It's on the ground, and Howard recovers.
Watch out there now.
Aaron Motley said, I'm not letting go. The graduate from Richmond, Virginia, coming up with the fumble recovery.
I'm going to just try to do some running after the catch and going down to the ground. That's Carson Hinton, number 21, with the strip. Motley recovers. First turnover of the day for the Spartans.
Okay now.
I go deep now. Quentin Williams can throw a good deep ball. I know you've been running it, but you got the turnover. Try and get this young man going, doing what he can do well.
Instead, they hand it off to Jared Hunter. Hunter picks up a couple.
And this is what Norfolk State does. When they get in trouble, they show you who they are. And who are they? Man-to-man across the board, not going to let you run the football. When they had a lead, they play some soft coverage, some soft zone. But when you see people running from one side of the field to the other,
Hunter, he's shooting running. Hunter just looked for the opportunity, the slight little crease or gap, he found it and picked up the first down.
Yeah, I like him. He's got some wiggle. He's got the ability to change direction quickly in small spaces. Good pad level. He'll be a good one.
That's where Howard has seen success on the ground today. 25 yards, better than 175 picked up on the ground. Here's Quentin Williams putting it in the air. And the pass is complete to Brennan Brown. Brennan Brown coming down with the grab. Excuse me, that's Christian Carter, the tight end.
That's that deep ball down the field outside. That's Williams' territory. That's where he likes to throw the ball. Good job making the catch. Even with an attempted low tackle.
Trying to make this a one-score game if they're able to punch it in. Here on homecoming, Williams keeping it slides for a few. And Quentin Williams, who had a touchdown already in this ball game, trying to engineer another score. Looking for some space. Wheeler gets around the edge and in.
He knows it's homecoming. Ian Wheeler knows it's homecoming.
Ian Wheeler with the my time to shine, his play time and night kind of run. And Howard
Realize it's homecoming.
Yeah, say we ain't going nowhere. We got to protect home field.
Yes, a little misdirection here. Wheeler, we know he's got the ability to finish off big runs. Nice dip move to the outside. Sniffs the goal line and gets it across. Nice play call from Lee Holm, but a fantastic job by Wheeler and the Howard offense. Because I want you to...
This is a Howard group who has put up big numbers against the number one rushing defense in the MEAC. A combination of things all combining with Ian Wheeler able to squeak in for the score.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
All smiles from Ian Wheeler as his team only down by a touchdown thanks to his terrific effort, Jay.
Fantastic. He knows that it's homecoming. This is a homecoming type effort we're seeing from Ian Wheeler doing it on several fronts.
Wheeler out of Houston, who's been busy and keeping that momentum, and now it's on Dawson Odom's crew to try to respond here and hold tight to their lead and add.
Yes. I mean, that, you know, we know that they can score points, but now for the first time in a long time, his offense comes on the field with a little bit of pressure. They cannot go three and out. They need to help out this defense and put some points on the board to increase the lead, because it seems as if Howard believes they can come back and get this game.
J.J. Davis on the return. Let's go back to Ian Wheeler and the last few plays that he's made.
That's why I said he knows it's homecoming. All the fourth quarter, we saw the kickoff return. That was a spark, able to finish off a 96-yard kickoff return. They needed that. And then what does he do? After he scores a touchdown, he comes down on special teams. And watch this. He makes the tackle on special teams, and then last time we saw, give me a little end around, a little oop, in, out, end zone, Ian Wheeler. That type of play inspired football.
He's been busy, and so have the Bison. 14 unanswered points. They come roaring back. There within striking distance as J.J. Davis is stopped by Brokenberg.
Now I think it's the time that Norfolk State's going to play a little bit closer to the chest, closer to the vest than we were used to them doing right now. They want to control clock and run the football with their running back by committee.
Instead, Carter puts it in the air, able to wiggle around a couple of defenders and near midfield. As that is DeKendall James, 25-yard pickup.
Juwan Carter. I mean, this is all Carter. I mean, this is a design run, but if you see something that you like, pull it, hit the backside slant, get it efficiently, get to the first down. See, if you're Howard, you got to crowd the line of scrimmage. The closest defensive back is 8 yards away from a wide receiver across the board. That's too clean a release.
They have not been able to bring pressure on Carter today, but they have been able to bottle up their running backs at points. J.J. Davis didn't have much room to run thanks to Christian White.
Greg Williams on the stop, along with number 25, Christian White.
So Williams, Christian White, Kenny Gallup, who's been busy on defense as well. You're on second and nine.
Now starting to get into it. Starting to hear the bison bells ringing in the back. A little atmosphere trying to make the Sparks a little bit uncomfortable here at Green Stadium.
Davis again stood up. And Darian Brokenberg, along with Aaron Walker, looking strong off the middle.
Number three can play. Brokenberg's good at clock in the middle. Active, able to do a swim move.
Big third down here for Norfolk State. Carter with time. Ellington stretching out, first down. And that will quiet the crowd for just a moment. But Juwan Carter, again, we've seen him pick apart the defense of the Bison.
Yeah, you'll see Ellington, watch him wall off the defensive back, Knighton,
completed catch and a first
using
down.
His frame.
The previous play is under review.
Ellington goes 6-6.
That's why it's under review currently, Jay.
Is the knee down?
Did he have possession going to the ground?
Ooh. I mean, I thought he caught it cleanly. Knee down, hits the ground, then it moves. I'm going to say knee down. I mean, that's what I'm saying. I'm going to say knee down. He's got the catch.
Okay.
Knees down, then he moves. Now, yeah, and that's a tap. I would say if he was leaving his feet, then I think you would call that incomplete. But I think the knee is down.
So this play under review. Remember, it was ruled a catch on the field. Edwards.
Been busy, hasn't
he? Yes, he has.
And this is the one, I mean, we saw it, said, whoa, wait a minute, but I think you have to say the catch and knees down.
After review, the ruling on the field of a completed catch and a first down is confirmed. The player's knee was down prior to the ball coming out. First down, Norfolk State.
Fans here, I can understand why they're booing. I don't know if they understand the complexity of the rules or how it works. They showed it on the Jumbotron, and everybody said, oh, they got excited like that was going to count as a stop. However, his knee was down to secure the first down catch.
The Spartan fans who traveled into the nation's capital, they're cheering on the other side. Everybody getting riled up, a little knuckety buck playing in the stadium.
You know your hip hop category.
I do. Empty backfield in the toss to J.J. Davis. J.J. Davis around the edge. First and goal, Spartans. 33-yard pickup.
Jet sweep. You know, he's going to outrun the linemen. Wide receivers doing a good job finishing blocks downfield. And be interesting to see where they mark him out. I thought he was a little bit closer. He goes out around the 4-yard line, so they put it on the 3.
Davis remaining in the backfield. Better than 7 minutes to go. They give it to Davis, and Davis is pulled down from behind by Antonio Turner.
Make it tough on him right now. If you're Howard, you have to be thinking that. Just don't. You get him to settle to a field goal, that's a big victory right now for the situation that you're in.
And an all-important drive for both squads. They want to see the Spartans stopped if you're Larry Scott. Cameron Britt, he's in! Britt with a 3-yard touchdown run. And that's a way to answer if you're Dawson Odom's crew.
Well done. A good football team knows other teams going to have a fight, try and come back in it. But a better football team answers. Nice drive from Norfolk State to increase the lead.
Spartans in their first conference game of the season.
False start. Offense, number 90. 5-yard penalty. Replay the try.
They want to be among the top teams. Currently South Carolina State. And Howard holding the number one spot. And the extra point is through. It's been a fun football game. Norfolk State had a big lead. Howard came in close. They say, Spartans need a little more separation.
Today, let's paint with New Bear Dynasty so that you can be proud of your walls.
Where's your furniture?
Oh, we thought it distracted from the New Bear Dynasty paint color. Let me take your coats.
Because Bear Dynasty only takes one coat.
Bear Dynasty.
Go ahead, throw your wine on it.
What?
Stain repellent.
It's also scuff resistant. You're paying for that.
Introducing Bear Dynasty, the best of Bear, exclusively the Home Depot.
Lowe's showrooms have a variety of stylish flooring you'll love for years to come. Like Pergo Wet Protect and Stainmaster, exclusively at Lowe's. Your life might change, but your flooring can last a lifetime. Order now. Get your flooring installed with help from Lowe's. Home to any budget, home to any possibility.
You're watching ESPN College Football presented by McDonald's. Well, Howard always in the mix. And right now, seeing everybody showing off a little bit. This is what I wish I could. It's my spirit animals right here. Like they're dancing. I love to dance, so I wish I could be out there. Get it. Good vibe, good atmosphere, good feels from Howard homecoming. And this has been an entertaining ball game, Jim.
They showed the fight. And 6.5 minutes, still plenty of time out there. Particularly if they can get a quick strike.
When we talk about just how involved Howard is, you'll see them a few times both on the gridiron and the basketball court. The HBCU New York Football Classic will be held at MetLife when the Bison take on Morehouse, and then 2022 NBA All-Star Game as a kickoff classic as well. And Howard,
Bison will roll deep. They will roll deep in New York. Now, I will tell you, I think the largest club on campus was the New York club when I was here. Probably still is. So they'll be deep at the God or at the stadium.
Will they be at Cleveland State?
Of course. It's Howard, everywhere. everywhere.
NBA also launching an HBCU fellowship program. We know Chris Paul, a Phoenix Suns point guard, executive producer of Why Not Us. You can check it out on ESPN Plus. Good pass there as Antoine Murray. And Murray, who is back for his COVID year, sixth season, they've needed his leadership. And excuse me, that's Casey Hawthorne.
Yeah, this is that seam route there. Nicely thrown ball. They found something in coverage. Typical Norfolk. Okay, you hit something with the zone. Next play, let's go back to our man-to-man coverage. They can beat us.
They pitch over to Wheeler. Wheeler, who's ran into his own teammate, bounce back a little bit, and Devin Coles makes the tackle.
And this is how they had to string it along. I mean, Wheeler's had the hot hand, but great job of attack by Stuart Anderson, number 20, able to win his battle, disrupt that play. Then Devin Coles finished it off. I'm still waiting for Howard to take the deep shot.
And the guy you single out, number 18, Matthew McDonald, instead, it's Quentin Williams who's scrambling, and Williams runs out near the 31-yard line, so that'll move the chains.
Picking up at least 10 yards, running the football as a quarterback. That'll keep your offense on the field and happy. Still have a little bit more sense of urgency. Let's get him up to the line.
Williams looking downfield, taking that shot, going on the outside, and Matthew McDonald is able to say, let me brush a little dirt off my jersey.
You know that Matthew McDonald is that 6'5" target. I always thought a little bit underutilized. Give him more chances to make catches like this. 50-50 ball, he's got enough size and length. Be a tough matchup going against that Brandon Savage, experienced cornerback. Big play.
Huge play for the senior. That helps the Bison to strike up the band. More importantly, down by one score. Matthew McDonald, you said target him on the outside, seek him out, he can haul it in, and Quentin Williams dialed it up.
Throwing the ball downfield, and once again, now it gets interesting. Norfolk State offense has to come on the field with a little bit of pressure. Howard offensively has figured out something here in the second half. They only had 3 points in the first half, now 28 points. In the second half, they really come to life in the fourth quarter.
But Jay, as you said, there's got to be perhaps something different for Troy Douglas to do defensively to stop this Norfolk State team. Because remember, the last time they had the ball, they scored.
Yeah, you have to leave your comfort zone. I think that's the key, leaving the comfort zone. And you know, there's a reason you play so much soft zone coverage. Maybe they lack confidence in the defensive backs, particularly in the secondary. But I'd rather give up the big play than let somebody just pick me apart like Norfolk State has been doing offensively all day.
Bringing it back is Kevin Johnson. And Johnson trying to run behind Stuart Anderson. And remember, this is a Norfolk State team, as you mentioned, Jay, had a 31-10 lead to start this quarter.
They were on cruise control. But you know what happened? They scored, and they kicked it off. And then Howard woke up.
And then Ian Wheeler happened.
The kickoff return came into play and found themselves in a football game.
Well, after dropping their first two games of the season to FBS opponents, the Spartans, winners of four straight, trying to extend it out to five. In a decade since they've been able to put together four in a row. Another critical drive coming up. Juwan Carter, we haven't seen him do it with his legs as often here today because he's had so much success through the air. 21 straight completions earlier. Kenny Gallup is able to stop him. Brings up second and short.
And Williams, quarterback of Howard, hoping he gets one more opportunity to get the football and tie up this game.
Beautiful fall. October day, the sun has been doing some funky things in the sky with cloud cover, and that's where the Spartans find it within their face, trying to drive the field. Pounded up ahead and able to get the first down on that J.J. Davis run.
You've got to crowd the line of scrimmage. You must leave yourself vulnerable to the big play pass, but you have to bring more men closer to the line of scrimmage. Look how many people, they've got 6 men in the box. They're outnumbered in the box. Maybe they're going to bring the safety down, but he's coming from 10 yards away. Show it. Let them know you're coming with your best run stop and blitz.
J.J. Davis side, trying to get to the edge, but a nice tackle, shoestring, trying to bring him down. And he was relentless on Ray Williams, able to stop him.
Here's what I'm talking about, right? You're trying to disguise. This is not disguise. Watch the safety number 12 that's chasing him down. He came from 10 yards deep and was going to get outrun to the point of attack trying to disguise. There's nothing to disguise. They're running the football right now. You have to crowd the line, make him audible to a pass. And if you're Norfolk State, keep doing it. If you're going to have a four-man defensive line front with two backers, pick a side, overpower it, pick up positive yards. Another first down. This game's over.
Carter keeps it. Runs into Aaron Walker and company. And right now, when you look at the, time for a timeout. Remember, they spent it on that two-point attempt earlier. So Howard already down to two timeouts. And the clock definitely not on their side. Larry Scott finally deciding to spend his second.
And it's tough because you don't want to spend a timeout when a team is in a pretty good position to get a first down on you. Third and two. You have to think Norfolk State likes their chances of converting.
Well, Jay, while we have this break, we'll remind our viewers that they want to check out Black College Live. We'll be in Birmingham, the Magic City Classic between Alabama State and Alabama A&M. You can find us on YouTube at Black College Live, also on the ESPN YouTube channel as well.
Yeah, good show today.
Yeah, it was.
From the yard, right?
Yeah. Dawson Odoms stopped by the show.
Thank all those that came out. Showtime band came. Ooh la la. For folks there.
Important third down play. Norfolk State has converted 6 of 12. They've got to pick up 2 yards and get to their own 45.
We're in the sink. I like that. You see the free safety is about 8 yards deep. He's the deepest line of protection you have, but you don't want him involved. You want somebody else to make a tackle close to the line of scrimmage to prevent them from getting this first down.
The handoff to Brent, and Brent has a gaping hole up the middle. And ladies and gentlemen, this should seal it. Touchdown, Spartans.
They gashed him. You know, part of the problem when you have a true freshman at free safety is your last line of defense. Every now and then they're going to take a poor angle.
Oh, you see the Spartan helmet being placed on top of the head of Cameron Brent after that 57-yard run to seal the game.
Like that little Spartacus look there. Spartan helmet, okay.
Yards of total offense for Norfolk State today.
And just, I mean, untouched. How does that happen? Game's on the line and your running back does not get, he didn't break a tackle. He went untouched into the end zone. Disappointing way to end the homecoming, it seems like, here for Howard. And Dawson Odom and his squad showing you they've got some mental toughness as well. Found themselves in a close contest and able to pull away.
Well, he told us this week, he took over a struggling Southern program. Took them to a SWAC championship multiple times over, won one back in 2013. When he looked at this Norfolk State program, he said, I got a blueprint. And not only that, Norfolk, he said, was a gym with a lot of dirt on it. But he said, one day, I believe, one day it will shine. And right here, another step closer to making it shine brighter.
I've heard that for years, that Norfolk could be a gym. And it seems like they got the right person to kind of bring that shine back, as you mentioned. Called out the fans a week ago for what he thought was a lackluster attendance for homecoming. I mean, that takes a lot to do that. But when he comes in there and says, hey, I've got the recipe. You know, you want to shop for the groceries or am I going to shop for the groceries? Justin Toller.
Let me tell you, but the cover wasn't bare. And when we mentioned, you know, the previous head coach, Latrell Scott, he said, you know, he did a great job of recruiting. And this was, you know, getting a sense of this would be their year. A very good offensive mind was Latrell Scott. He just made a couple of adjustments here and there. And he said all we did was kind of change some of the mindset because they've always had the talent.
And down there in that 757 area code where football's a way of life. And also, I mean, Odom's a smart guy. If I'm a head coach, I want to take over a program where I've got the best quarterback in the conference as well. Makes my life a little bit easier.
And Williams tripped up and brought down by Deshaun Dixon. And this is a young man, we said, who's got NFL talent trying to get a selection to that.
That'll be a big opportunity for him.
Again, pocket collapsing, pressure. Williams goes down. Well, again, you go back to Dawson Odoms, who loves to see the defense here.
They're doing it. I mean, it's what they want to do. You get a lead late, obvious pass situation, you tell your D-line, go eat. Run, attack the pocket, get the quarterback, get him down. Good job responding by the front four, Norfolk State.
When we heard Odoms talk about why he's been successful, what are his ingredients? Talked about, you know, loving players and caring for players. And right now, he's got the Spartans playing for him, playing inspired.
Yeah, I'm giving him respect. I mean, I've had him at number three for the last 2 weeks now. Jackson State, Prairie View, those are the squads right there that are playing very well. But Norfolk, the right now, best team I've seen in the MEAC. And, you know, at the end of the day, the winner of the SWAC will play the winner of the MEAC in the Cricket Celebration Bowl down in Atlanta, Georgia for the championship. But I think Norfolk State had an opportunity today to prove they are the real deal, and I think they passed with flying colors.
Searching for their first winning season in more than a decade.
Yeah, how about this? They got to their point. You know, Norfolk State's an offense where when they got this win streak going, they've been with 44 points a game. They got to 45. That lets you know they're clicking offensively.
And as fourth and 22 comes up for Howard, you also have to pay off Larry Scott and the job that, you know, he's done, because he's put the Bison in a position that they hadn't been in a while. And now he's got this group believing again. You can see the building blocks and pieces that he's putting in place in his first season.
Program's in good hands, fellas. You know, people always ask me, I'll just tell you. They're in good hands. This is going to be a much improved football team. Consider they've got four freshmen starting on the offensive line. They've got some good runners there. He's a good recruiter. Better days are ahead for the Bison.
Right now,
39 seconds remaining on the clock. And Dawson Odoms and Norfolk State want to soak up this experience. You mentioned earlier, felt disrespected that they were scheduled for homecoming. And he wanted to come in here and prove a point.
Has to be a sweet feeling for Norfolk State. Six tight diamond formation, call that victory formation. Getting ready to take a knee at Howard for their homecoming. Challenging little road trip, but it feels real sweet right now. They did a fantastic job coming in here and controlling this football game.
Well, Juwan Carter just showed off 26 of 29 for 332 yards to go along with a touchdown as well. And this young man has continued to impress throughout the season, but he also got help on the ground with Cameron Brent. Obviously his favorite target, Justin Smith. They hope he's okay. Behold, they say in Norfolk, the green and gold. Spartans looking to turn heads in the MEAC, and Norfolk State winners of five straight under first-year head coach Dawson Odoms. And we know all he does is win.
Win, win, win. How long will it go? Got a couple teams, particularly South Carolina State, I'm sure, keeping an eye on them. And Norfolk State right now, the pride of the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, highest ranked team out there, the winning continues.
Well, Norfolk State came in with a purpose. Juwan Carter says, I know the assignment. The Spartans coming up with big play after big play, catapulting them to a 45-31 victory, spoiling Howard's homecoming. For Jay Walker and the rest of our great crew, Optic Green saying so long.